Ambassador Mark Lippert has been speaking with his parents. They live in Ohio, and his father, Jim, joins me now. Jim, thank you so much. I can't imagine that call that you got and how relieved you must be that your son is recovering. How is he doing, and just how badly was he hurt?
Well, he's doing as well as can be expected. He's out of any serious physical difficulty. He's recovering. He had 80 sutures to the deep laceration on his face. He had an operative procedure on his upper left extremity. He said he had some numbness, another discomfort in his fourth and fifth digits of his left hand, the ring and small finger, which he surmises will be remediated through physical therapy post-operatively.
What does he remember about what happened, how this attack unfolded?
What Mark related to me was that he was at this event. He heard noise, commotion, if you will, I believe to his rear. And he indicated to me that he had been in other venues where individuals would come up to him and be pretty vocal. But it was all of a talk nature. And so what he surmised was that this assailant, who he didn't know was going to be assailant at that time, was going to address him verbally. But quickly at that time, apparently he turned and he had really no defense for the assault that then ensued.
And I know your son has served tours in Iraq and Afghanistan. When you spoke to him, did he talk about that, his experience in the military? Did that help him?
Well, he did say that he thought that his training and service did help him from the standpoint that he was more steady. He indicated that he understood the dynamics of what was going on, and he understood how he should react. And that reaction was that he maintained calm, didn't become hysterical so as to excite others. He understood that he had to leave the venue or the place where the assault occurred for medical treatment, and he really didn't know what was going to ensue, if there was a second wave or any other disturbance that was going to occur. And then, of course, he knew he needed medical treatment, and that was appropriately administered to him on a expeditious basis.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Jim. I appreciate it. And you're taking the time tonight, and our best to your son as he gets better.
Yeah, thank you very much.